Hello everyone, welcome to Beaver's Hobby channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to upgrade the electronics in Firelap IW04M. I already talked about basic RC car electronics and how to set up in my WL Toys electronics upgrade video. So, if you are a beginner and just starting to learn about RC, I recommend you to follow the link on the top right corner or in the description to watch it. With that out of the way, let's get started. To upgrade the electronics in IW04M, first, you need a transmitter and receiver, preferably the one that has small receiver. Don't choose one with massive receiver like this, because it won't fit. So once again, I choose radio link. Next is the ESC. I'm using a cheap, small 20mm ESC off eBay, and this one has a switch to turn the brake on and off. I'm going to leave it on, because this is a car and I need brake. Then the servo. I'm using the Emax ES08MD2. It has perfect servo horn position and length for this car. All of these can run off 4 nickel metal hydride batteries. To start planning what goes where, let's disassemble it down to bare chassis. First, remove the battery and motor trays. Then remove the center shaft. And remove the circuit board. This board is going to be replaced by ESC and receiver, and the batteries are going to connect to the ESC with these wires. My plan is to solder all the wires from the ESC and the servo directly to the receiver, so I can make it as small as possible, and the car looks clean without the wires going everywhere. Let's start with the receiver. To make it as small as possible, I'll desolder all the pins out. I have seen people just cut the pins and solder the wires to them. But I'm not going to do that, because I want it to be as flat as possible, otherwise it won't fit. I start preparing it by taking it out of the case. And remove the black plastic part, so the pins can come off easily. Use a small flathead screwdriver to slowly teasing it out. Be careful not to damage any component on the board, or break the receiver in half. As for the ESC, I'm cutting the wrap off so I can test fit it inside the car for now. Later, I'll swap all the wires to be on the other side of the board. Now I have to figure out where to put these boards on the chassis. This is how they are going to go in. ESC at the back and receiver at the front. This way they won't interfere with the center shaft, servo and motor tray. Before going any further, let's cut the standoff poles for the original board off, because I'm not going to use them anymore. Next, let's deal with the servo horn. The original servo horn from this car is not working with this servo, so I have to make one. Luckily, the included horn has a hole at the right length, so just drill it with 1.5mm drill bit. And insert a short M2 screw in. Cut the horn to size. And it is done. Let's test it before moving on. Yes, it is working perfectly. I also have to set the endpoint on the transmitter really low, so it's not popping off the steering rod like this. Now everything is ready for soldering. But before that, you should take note what each pin is connected to, so you can do the soldering without making any mistake. Here is what I use for this ESC. Let's start by desolder all the pins out of the receiver. On the ESC, first remove the brake switch. and bridge the inner two spots to turn the brake on permanently. Then remove all the wires because I want to put them on the other side. Now put the ESC and receiver together, starting from the three wires from ESC to receiver. Measure and cut the wires just enough to connect two boards together. Then strip. Tin. And solder them onto channel 2 on the receiver. White is signal. Red is positive. And black is the ground. Next are motor wires. I use the original wires with ring, so it's easier if I need to swap the wires to change the motor direction. Color of the polarity is not important here because I can swap them when connecting to the motor anyway. Then solder the battery wires on. I leave them long for now, so I can test fit and cut them later. And finally, don't forget the on-off switch. Now that we know the size of the whole board, let's do the servo. Again, measure and cut the wires to be just enough. For this servo, yellow is signal, red is positive, and brown is ground. Solder them to the channel 1 on the receiver. What left now is to solder the battery trays to the ESC. Again, measure the wires, cut, tin, remove the old wires, and then solder the new ones on. And it is done. Let's test if everything is working correctly before putting it in the car. Putting the car back together is almost the opposite of disassembling it, except the first step is to glue the ESC and receiver down with hot glue. Obviously, you need to take the servo off for this and mount the battery trays onto the chassis first. Apply the glue only just enough to hold the balls down. If you apply too much, the balls will sit higher and might rub against the center shaft. I also use hot glue to hold down the wires that bridge between battery trays. Next one to go on is the center shaft. and then the servo. Unfortunately, the motor tray doesn't have enough room for wires, so a bit of trimming is needed. Now that it fits snugly onto the chassis, screw everything down from the bottom, and the car is almost finished. Now put the motor in. And then put the top plate on. And run the wires through it. The wires that are coming out of the top are motor wires, both from the motor and ESC, switch and the antenna. Now put all the knuckles back on. I also take this opportunity to upgrade the front knuckles to 1.5 degree camber from MiniZ MA010. Once that's done, screw the top plate on. And the motor wires too. Now I can curl up the antenna and tuck it away from the motor to avoid interference. Then strap the switch down with cable tie. And the car is complete. Now it's time to set up the ESC. First, check the function to see if it goes when you pull the trigger. Then, brake when you switch directly from pulling to pushing the trigger. Then come back to center and push it again to go the opposite direction. If not, you have to reverse the channel 2 on the transmitter. Then check the direction. If it goes the wrong way, you have to swap the wires on the motor. Remember, check if the functionality is correct first, then the car direction later. If the ESC doesn't have brake, the forward function should be faster than reverse. And that's how you spot if you need to reverse the channel 2 or throttle channel. You can see that now the steering is precise and also faster than before. Throttle is also pretty smooth. I actually find this ESC works better with nickel metal hydride batteries than 2-cell LiPo battery. Now the car is much better to drive. The turning circle is about 50 cm, and more importantly, equally from left to right. The speed is still slow, but I find it perfect for my tiny room. Now I can drift with confidence. It really was a hassle to modify, but the reward is also high. The looming question is, am I recommending this car after getting it to run pretty well? The answer is yes and no. You shouldn't get it as your first car, but yes, if you already have some experience fixing RC car. Keep in mind that there's a lot of trouble to get it working, and even after that, there's still some drawbacks that can't be fixed. Like the universal shaft doesn't fit knuckle properly even after I upgrade it to MiniZ original knuckle. The wheels wobble almost all the time. You have to do a lot of shimming for this. And the biggest drawback of all is the starting cost. At $72, this car is too expensive for what it is. But if you have resource and time to fix, it's a good project car with good looking body and a nice challenge to get it working. And that's it for this video. Please subscribe if you want to see more content like this, and press the bell icon to get notification whenever I upload a new video. You can follow me on Facebook to see what I'm doing between videos, along with some quick updates. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.